I'm drunk.
Robert Paltok was an attorney, a Cornishman, who didn't really write a novel until he was 54, and it's called Peter Wilkins and the Flying Indians.
Peter Wilkins
and the Flying Indians. And it's said to be like a mixture of Robinson Crusoe and Gulliver's Travels, but in fact it's like neither. Partly because the island that he gets to is an extraordinary, fantastic place where there's an underground passage within a huge magnetic rock. And inside this huge magnetic rock, there is an inland sea with woods and lawns and all sorts of plants and strange birds and fishes. And he lives there, like Robinson Crusoe does, for a number of years. But unlike Robinson Crusoe, it's full of a sense of delight and wonder at the world around him. And it's reached in this magical way. And curiously, while he's there, he keeps hearing these voices in the air and wonders what on earth they are. And then one day, after he's been there for many years, he hears a bang on the hut, roof of the hut that he's built. He goes to see what it is. And it's a woman, landed on the ground. And he thinks at first that she's wearing a beautiful garment. Then he realises it's a garment rather like skin. In fact, it's a woman rather like a flying fox, actually covered in a sort of membrane with which she flies. And she's a member of a nation and a tribe who fly from this island somewhere near the South Pole and sometimes visit this remote outpost. He falls in love with her and marries her. And then later on the book changes direction because it becomes not a utopia, as people have said, but in fact a sort of reply to the conquistadors. He goes to visit this people who are a Stone Age culture, I suppose we would call them now, and he offers them civilization and brings them to a state where they, for example, get rid of slavery, where they make use of metal for all sorts of conveniences. And it's an extraordinary celebration of civilized existence. So it's an extremely optimistic work, and about, as I say, what might have happened if Europe had colonized or at least encountered South America in a different way from what it had done. It's an extremely humane work, full of attacks on slavery, full of sympathy for, very much admired by Coleridge, who thought it was one of the most beautiful love stories ever read.
What sort of date is this then?
It's 1752, if I remember right.
And is it in print still?
No. It was in the old Everyman, and if you go to eBay, you'll find lots and lots of copies of it, doubtless, in the old Ernest Rhys Everyman's Library, published at the beginning of the century. And I do recommend it. It's an entrancing
P-A-L-T-O-C-K,
a Cornishman.
Duncan sailor, what shall we do with a Duncan sailor? What shall we do with a Duncan sailor? In the morning, put him in the longboat till he's sober. Put him in the longboat till he's sober.